What's up, everyone? Today we're in a place called Hpa-An. We got here yesterday from Yangon. We ended up getting a coach that lasted around 6 to 7 hours. Really good coach. I was actually surprised. I thought it was really comfortable. And that cost around 6,000 per person. So yeah, I thought that was a really good price as well. And right now we're in the guest house. This is called Princess Guest House, and it was $23. And that includes a simple breakfast. So yeah, pretty good price for Myanmar. And as you can see, it's pretty good. Spacious, got the much needed AC as well. And the plan for today is that we're gonna do a hike up a really big mountain nearby. I think it's about 15 minutes away by vehicle. So yeah, we're just gonna head down and try and find a tuk-tuk or a taxi of some sort to take us there. And then we'll start the hike. All right, so we've arrived at the mountain. It's called Mount Zwegabin. We just got a tuk-tuk here. It costs 4,000 to get here, probably about a 15-minute ride, I think. And it also costs 4,000 to enter the mountain part. The monk at the bottom just gave us this little wristband to show that we've paid. And you could probably see how massive this mountain was from the shots that I got from the tuk-tuk. So it's gonna be quite a walk. I think it's gonna take about an hour and a half, 2 hours to get to the top. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Yeah, we're dead already. So the trail is just steps, constant steps. I think I read there's over 4,000 steps going up. And we've entered on the east side of the mountain. So on the east side, you can get steps all the way up. Whereas on the west side, I think half of it's steps, half of it's trail. So it's supposed to be harder. Harder but quicker, the west side. So yeah, like I said, we came up the east side and we're gonna go down the west side, so we'll still be able to see the other side of the mountain. But you're definitely gonna need loads of brakes, that's for sure. How are you finding it?
Very hard. It's hard to breathe.
Yeah. So we're probably about halfway now. The steps have the numbers on them, so we're just approaching 1,500. Feels like a lot more though. And you get some amazing views here. Check how high we are. It's kind of misty, so you can't really see properly, but yeah, it gives you an idea of how high we've climbed. And you'll see here, this is how steep the steps are. It's crazy. So just all the way down there, just zigzagging. A few monkeys around there as well. I'll try and film some later. Hello.
Hello, Menglava.
Trash?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay.
Hello.
Hello. So we got a few monkeys here. You can see that one there just chilling. Big guy. He's on the move now. So you can see you got some pretty cool rock structures here on the cliffside. Not sure what kind of rock this is. Whoa. And I think right now we're at the last hurdle. Does look pretty beautiful here right now. When you're in the shade, it's actually okay. There's a kind of cool breeze, but when you're in the sun, it's just so hot. I think it's over 30 degrees Celsius now. Yeah, so pretty hardcore. We actually saw a kid being carried down. His head was bleeding and his leg was bandaged up, so he must have fell somewhere. I don't know how he did that because the path isn't dangerous, but I don't know, he must have been walking off the path or something. So you definitely gotta watch out. The hardest trail ever?
Yes.
I think it's the hardest one we've ever done, right?
Because it's like almost 2 hours or 1 hour and a half and just steps.
Steps constantly going up.
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. So we finally made it at the top. Just found some shade straight away. Bought Coke for energy and water. So that was 2000. And here at the top we have a monastery, a Buddhist monastery. So check out that awesome pagoda. You can see here everyone's resting like us. Everybody's tired. Now we gotta stay here for 3 hours to rest. Yeah, 2 days. Yeah, once we've rested, we'll walk around a bit at the top and I'll show you some of the views. Guys, so check this out. We have a glass floor. I had no idea. Whoa. It's really misty, right?
Yeah.
Can't really see properly.
Yeah, when it's far, I can't see.
Yeah. But you can see the mountain goes all the way on down there into the distance. Here's another angle of the awesome pagoda. this side, you get a lot better view. Visibility is pretty good. So there's actually four pagodas here. One pagoda on each mountaintop. Then back there you can see other mountains. Ours is the highest one here though in the region. So we're gonna be heading out now. Really cool that there's a monastery to see at the top. Quite a lot of people there. Today is a holiday, Independence Day holiday. So yeah, quite a few people, but still not that busy at all. And now we're gonna be heading down here. So this is the west side. We'll see how the path is on the west side. Going down should be okay though. As you can see on this side now, visibility is a bit better. So yeah, it should be a pretty cool scenic path on the way down. See all the mountains there. Awesome. Let's go. So this behind us is the trail part that I was talking about. So if you had to go up this way, yeah, this part would be horrible because it's very slippy as well. So all the way down here, just a trail, no steps. So we have finally made it to the bottom of the other side of the mountain. And here at the bottom is a place called Lumbini Garden. And it basically just features 1,000 Buddha statues. So literally all the way around, there's just these old Buddha statues everywhere. And then also on the other side of the road, there's many others. So they say there's over 1,000, which is crazy. So check that out, they are pretty worn out from all the weather, especially the ones with no cover on the top. So the statues are pretty much all identical, I think. All the same meditation pose. And then look in the background there, that's what we just climbed. Epic mountain. How are you feeling after the hike?
I can't feel my legs.
Yeah, my knees are shaking.
Yeah, my knees are also shaking.
They keep locking up. It's kind of hard to believe, but we climbed all the way to that far point over there. It's So all the way back there, crazy. But you still have the rest of all this mountain here. And here we got some refreshing water. Much needed. This spot really is cool though, I've never seen anything like this before. Non-stop Buddha statues. Having to get the motorbike back, a moto taxi. The guy charged, I think, 6,000. There wasn't no tuk-tuks or anything around. So we ended up getting that. And then we also went to a local restaurant that we've been going to here. And we had an absolute feast. I think it ended up costing 6,800. And that was with tea and I think 3 cans of soda. So yeah, loads of food and just so cheap. Food here so far in the local places has been extremely cheap. There's even been days where me and Carol have paid just $2 to $3 for the both of us for a lot of food as well. So yeah, maybe one of the cheapest places that we've been for food so far, I think. And it's still early today, but just because we're so exhausted, there is no chance we're going to do anything else. I'm probably just going to edit a video or something on YouTube, upload another video. And tomorrow we were planning on doing a bicycle ride. Our legs are pretty much gone. I'm pretty sure they're going to be aching a lot tomorrow. So I think we're going to get a scooter instead. We'll rent a scooter. And there's still a lot of other cool stuff to visit here. Viewpoints, supposed to be some awesome caves, some other temples, stuff like that. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it because you saw how awesome this place looked today. So yeah, it's going to be good exploring more of it. So thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. And we'll see you in the next one.